Hi, today we'll be talking about how to move your Bitcoin out of your hot wallets and how to keep them in cold wallets. In order to explain you that, we will briefly talk about what is the difference between a hot wallet and a cold wallet, and how can you create a cold wallet and move your Bitcoin from hot wallet into cold wallet. Very quickly, what is a wallet? A wallet is a blockchain address, and that's about it. Every blockchain address or wallet has a private key to itself. This private key is the game changer in terms of hot wallet and cold wallet, where you keep this private key. So this private key or password is what enables anybody to move money out of your wallet or out of your address. For example, if you want to move money out of your blockchain address, you will have to feed in your private key. Or when you move money out of your blockchain addresses or wallets such as Zepay or Poloniex, they already have your private key and they feed it in for you. Now you might get confused with the passwords you write for Zepay, the 4-digit password or the fingerprint, or the 2FA you do on Poloniex or using Google Authenticator, etc. Those are not private key. Those passwords are specific to these apps and website. However, private key is specific to blockchain, and every blockchain address and wallet, no matter which company is using it, has a private key. Now, these websites and apps are called hot wallets because your password or key is already with them. You mostly will not even get it. They already have it. You will be asked to feed in another way of authentication that's easier to remember, like 4-digit PIN or a password or a Google Authenticator number, etc. You will generally not even have to feed in your PIN because they already have your PIN, password. Every time you ask for money to be sent out of your wallet or address, say on Poloniex you want to send out 2 bitcoins and buy Ethereum from it, they will put in your private key on your behalf because they already have it. So now what happens is, because your private key is with them, it's kept on the server, a hacker can break into the server and steal your private key. And should a hacker steal your private key, the hacker can move out Bitcoin from your address to his address using this private key, and no 2FA and no PIN will even be required. This private key will solve it for them. Hence, if your private key gets compromised, your Bitcoins can get stolen, and hackers are sitting day in, day out and compromising private keys. So it's advised not to leave your Bitcoin on hot wallets, on apps, etc., because their private key, your private key is on digital world. This was all about hot wallets and the way keys work on them. Now come to cold wallet. What's the difference in cold wallet? Wallet is an address. Cold storage address, what happens is that the password, the private key password that comes with it, it's not ever put on digital media. You've never put it on anybody else's server. You don't even put it on your own server, your own email, your own computer that is connected to internet. Never ever bring it to the digital world. Let's come back to basic of hacking. Hackers are digital thieves. They are not physical world thieves. So they can only store and steal something that's on digital medium from the internet. Now, how to generate a wallet with a password that stays offline? Go to bit address. The moment you have gone to bit address, take your computer off wired internet, wireless, Bluetooth, anything that connects it to the outside world, just take it off. Make sure your computer is not connected to anything. Your website will work offline. This is meant to work offline. You have to move your mouse zigzag, 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 and they'll be running a counter from 0 to 100%. As soon as it becomes 100%, a new page will open with a blockchain address and a password. Remember that the address is on the left and the password is on the right. There are 2 QR codes. Left QR for address, right QR for password. Left QR for address in alphanumeric, typable form, and right QR, and right below that there is an alphanumeric, that's your private key or password. This private key or password has never ever to go on internet. Now you will need the address to scan it or to write it in different places for you to send money to it in future. So either you can write those 2 alphanumeric characters and make sure it's correct because they are very long, or you can print out this paper. Should you want to print this screen out so that you always know your password and address, Make sure the printer you're connecting your computer to is an offline printer, is not connected in any way to the outside world through its own Wi-Fi or your home Wi-Fi or any other Wi-Fi or any other cord. Connect your computer to the printer using the cord. Don't use wireless connection between your printer and laptop. Remember, we have to avoid all means of getting on the internet. So connect it using cord, nothing else. Print it out. And then just forget the bit address. And this is your, this paper, or if you're writing in hand, this paper is your blockchain address and your private key for cold storage. Now, how do you transfer your Bitcoin to this cold storage? Not all Bitcoin apps support cold storage. One of them which do is Blockchain. It's called Blockchain. Go to the app store, download it, set it up. Usually it'll just ask you for your email address verification, set it up. There's another detailed video on how to set up your ZepPay or Poloniex or Blockchain. You can refer to them should you need to. Set up your Blockchain app. It'll ask you to generate a PIN or a fingerprint password. Do that. Once you have done that, go on the left top menu, the three horizontal lines. It's called hamburger menu. Go there. A drop down will come. Go to Bitcoin addresses or blockchain addresses. Click that. A new page will come. The second option will be import addresses. Hit the plus sign on the right. When it does, there'll be a camera button. Hit that and scan the left side QR code. You can also write the address. They'll give you the space to write it, or you can scan. I scan it. I find it easier. Scan the left side QR code and it'll take the address. It'll feed it in. You will see that it will automatically generate the alphanumeric address that was at the bottom of the QR code. It'll understand that it's this address. It'll ask you to give a nickname that you'll remember. You can give it my first private cold storage, because you will go on changing your cold storage, will cover why. So you can just do one, two, my first, second, third. Give it a name, and that's that. You've set up your cold storage. When you do that, it'll tell you that it is a read-only or a watch-only storage. That's all right. What it means is that you can't send the money out unless you feed the password, and there's a bit of process to that also. We'll cover that also in another video, how to get money from cold to hot again. So it'll give you a bit of warning. That's okay. It has gotten your cold address. Now leave it at that. Now go to the hot wallet you use, say ZepPay or Poloniex. I'll explain with ZepPay. Hit send on the home page. It'll ask you for the address. Again, you can type in the cold storage address, or you can turn on your camera and scan the QR code in the print you have, and it'll understand the address. Once it has the address, it'll ask you how many bitcoins to send to this address. Type in the bitcoins you want to send and just hit send. It will in all probability ask you for the pins or the password, FA, depending on which wallet you're using. Once you have put your 2FA, your pins, etc., the apps will themselves put in your private key, because they already have it. Your Bitcoin will go to your cold storage, and now it will stay safely in your cold storage. Nobody has a pin to it, no exchange has it, no hacker has it, because you never put it on the internet. So now you're safe. In which condition should you use cold storage? See, people buy Bitcoin for two reasons. One is to trade. Every time it goes high, they sell. Every time it comes low, they buy. The other kind of people who buy it are investors, who buy it to keep it for 3 months, 6 months, 1 year. It's usually the investors who should put it in cold storage. Traders should also, the first kind should also, but it's a little cumbersome to bring money from hot to cold and cold to hot. But for investors, I would recommend that it is definitely cold storage. Also, while we are on this, there are so many different kind of cold storage. You can, just the way we said, print it out on a paper. You could write it on a paper, or you could put it on a pen drive. Make sure you never connect that pen drive to anything that's connected to internet. Or there are devices called Treasure. There's so many companies making devices that would hold the private keys in for cold storage, etc. So there are a lot of other ways. We covered one today. The other ways we'll cover very briefly in a subsequent video, for you to know what are the other options. So this was about what are hot and cold storage, how can you create a cold storage, and how can you move your Bitcoin from hot storage to a cold storage. Should you have any more questions, you can leave them at hello@blockchainsemantics.com, and we'll be very happy to come back and help you with all answers you need. Till then, happy investing. Have a great time.